Okay, great opening statements, guys. Just a reminder, audience, from this point on, we'd like to save our applause till the end so that we can get through these questions. Just for your edification, these questions were chosen by the Tea Party Leadership Committee, and these questions were designed to address our core values. So we hope that each of the candidates will take time to specifically address the question and help us to understand what it is about our exact values that you can bring to the table as it relates to the issues that are affecting us in our current state. We're gonna start the questions with Congressman Brady. You drew first. The first question. This year we've heard about the czars, executive orders removing restrictions on Interpol, and we've seen bureaucracy such as the EPA attempt to set policy by expanding their own regulatory oversight. How much can an individual congressman do to restore the balance of power between the executive and the legislative branch?
I think there's a lot we can do to restore that balance, and it is way out of whack, as you and I all know. What we've done. What? As House conservatives, what we've done is introduce legislation to stop czars, funding for any more czars, require them to go through the appointment process, because we can't have unelected people in charge of huge swaths of our government, of our economy, of anything in America. We have tackled the executive orders. We have stepped forward on stopping the spending in Washington. You asked, in addition to the czars,
executive orders, bureaucracies, is it the EPA attempt to expand their own regulatory control without going through you guys?
Yeah, Marsha Blackburn and I and a number of conservatives introduced legislation to stop the EPA from regulating greenhouse gases. They have no business doing it. It will have a huge impact on Texas. They draw a circle around Texas. We're the ones who pay the greatest number of job losses if cap and trade goes through, and it really caps prosperity in America. We've introduced that legislation, and we've started a petition on the House floor to force a House vote on it. In every issue, I think, that has affected, I think, this country in a terrible way, from the stimulus spending, which we fought against, and now we are fighting against the second stimulus, from the auto bailout, which I opposed, the housing bailout, cash for clunkers, the Obama budget, every spending thing. Yeah, and I'll tell you what, I did vote for that first bailout. I didn't want the irresponsibility of Wall Street spreading down to our communities, our small businesses, our nest egg. But they didn't use the money anywhere close to what they promised. I'm experienced enough to know sometimes they don't. But I'll tell you what, we've introduced legislation to stop the TARP, end it, and return all bailout monies to the taxpayers today.
Thank you. Mr. Baker.
Well, you know that whole Constitution that we keep talking about? There's no power in there. One of the things that we can do, there's no power that allows for the creation of the czars. It's not a constitutional position. Every position is supposed to be appointed by the Senate. It's supposed to be confirmed, appointed by the executive. One of the best things we can do is to get us back to a constitutional government, a limited government. It's the same thing with the judiciary. They've way overstepped their bounds. The executive is overstepping its bounds. We've twisted it. The Constitution has the separation of powers, and it's very specific in the way it's set up. And if you read the history behind it, you can read the Federalist Papers, the Anti-Federalist Papers. They extensively cover why they did what they did and why they broke it out. There's things that we can do, just like we need to go after, we need to take an active role as legislators against the courts, as well as the executive branch. In 1802, Jefferson went after the courts and actually fired 18 of 35 judges and shut them down. Well, we need to go after those jobs. One of the ways we can do that is with the power of the purse. We have the power to say, we're going to defund these organizations, we're gonna drastically cut the funding, until they get in line with what they're supposed to be doing. And some of them, I think we should just defund, period, and not give them funding back. The EPA has no regulatory authority, that it should not have any regulatory authority. There's no reason why they should be regulating carbon dioxide. Propositions like cap and trade, cap and tax, they will crush our economy, they will crush our businesses, and there's no reason why we need to do any of them. And that's why we have to work so hard to kill those bills. I mean, we are working right now to do that. Unfortunately, the people that are there right now have stretched the bounds of what the Constitution is supposed to cover. And it's been, and it's not just the last 10 years, it's been over the last 100 and the last 50 years that we've gotten further away. Well, now is the time for us to stand up as people, as a group of people, as Americans, and stop it.
Thank you. Mr. Russell.
I love listening to everybody's answers. I love listening to everyone's answers because we've gone on and round in circles and talked about all kinds of things. There's only two important things here. I'm going to keep it really short because there's really no need to continue rambling on and on about other issues when the question was about federal government expansion and the czars. I agree. We've got to get every one of our government officials through a confirmation hearing at least so we know what people are representing our executive branch. I know from the question, and I also know from being a member of Tea Party organizations myself, how tired we are of the expansion of the executive branch. How many of you are tired of having executive orders forced through without Congress having a chance to look at them? How many of you are tired of the president overstepping his bounds, whether Republican or Democrat? We've had it on both sides. It is time that the legislative branch take back the power that was given to them by the founding fathers in the Constitution. If we don't do that soon, it's going to be too late. I just want to make sure that everybody understands that the legislature does have the authority to make these changes now. They don't have to just say, well, you know, we'll work harder next time or whatever. They can fix this today. And part of our pledge that my wife put on this wall says that we're going to try to keep our government in check. As American people, we keep them in check, and they can keep the executive branch in check. And we need to work on that starting today.
Mr. Franco.
See if I can answer without fading back. How do you restore the balance between the executive and the legislative branch? Well, it's easy. You elect members of Congress that have the spine to stand up to the president. People who have the guts to say that this isn't constitutional. This agency does not need to be funded. This needs to stop. If you think the people currently in office are going to do that, then you know you might as well just close the doors and shut the place down. You have to elect new leaders who are willing to stand up and take the bold positions to say this is unconstitutional. This funding needs to stop. We've got to cut back on spending because the people currently in office, they've had their chance, they've blown it, and they're not going to address the issues. You have to have new leaders. That is how you restore the power. You have people who stand up, who will speak boldly, and who have the guts to stand up to the president, that will stand up to Nancy Pelosi and all these other people. You know, I think that if you don't have the guts to stand up on the campaign trail, I don't think that you're going to hack it in Washington, D.C. So that's how you restore the power.
Thank you, Mr. Franco. All right, round one.